Hello everyone. If you pay attention, you will see that there are hundreds of different types of airplanes in the world. However, when it comes to passenger jet planes, there are only two giants dominating this field, Boeing and Airbus. But now, Chinese newspapers write that these two giants will be threatened by a company from China when recently this Chinese company has launched its first commercial flight using an airplane made by China itself. So has China been able to produce its own commercial airplane and can they now confidently live without us? Let's find out together. A little bit about China's new airplane. For a long time, Chinese leaders have determined that they cannot let the West dominate the aircraft manufacturing industry forever. So, in 2007, they approved a project called C-919, a national key project in passenger aircraft manufacturing. This airplane is manufactured by the China Aerospace Corporation, COMAC, a state-owned company. The C-919 model is intended to be a commercial airplane in the same segment and competing with the Boeing 737 MAX and Airbus A320 in the commercial aviation market. In 2008, the C-919 project was launched and production began in December 2011. The first airplane was completed at the end of 2015. In May 2015, the C-919 took off for the first time and that first flight was successful. However, COMAC also had to deal with many technical errors and many design changes. It took 5 years for completion and updates until September 2022 when the C-919 was certified by the Civil Aviation Administration of China. The first C-919 was delivered on December 9, 2022 and put into commercial passenger use on May 28, 2023, nearly a month ago. So is the C-919 big or not? Basically, the C-919 is a slightly smaller airplane with dimensions similar to the Airbus A320, a popular model used worldwide. It is 38 meters long, 6 meters high and has a body diameter of 3.95 meters. The tail height is 11.95 meters and the wingspan is 35.8 meters. This iron bird can accommodate from 156 to 168 passengers and can fly up to a maximum distance of 5,555 kilometers. Chinese media were extremely excited. They considered this a new miracle of China and at the same time emphasized that this important event was like a symbol for China's growing strength in the global aerospace industry. However, whether this airplane is safe or not, whether it is durable and operates stably or not is unknown, but many people have expressed their opinion that even if they were given money, they would not dare to sit on an airplane made by China. Not to mention many others who wonder if this airplane is really made by China when many components used, especially important ones, are imported from the US and Western countries. For example, one of the most important and difficult parts to manufacture of a commercial jet plane is its engine. But for C-919, it uses CFM LEAP-1A jet engines manufactured in France. It is manufactured by a joint venture between French engine manufacturers and a parent company based in the United States. CFM LEAP-1A also equips Boeing 737 MAX and Airbus A320 airplanes. Next is the flight control system, an important device responsible for interpreting pilot input information and moving flight control systems to control fuel consumption of airplanes. This system is manufactured by Parker Aerospace of USA. More specifically, there are more than 60 components making up this system. Furthermore, electrical systems and landing gear of Chinese jet planes are manufactured by Honeywell, another company based in USA. Tires, cockpit equipment and simulation systems are manufactured by Michelin, Eaton and Rockwell Collins, all based in USA. According to a report on Nikkei Asia, about 40% of core components of airplanes come from Western suppliers. So what does China produce? The answer is that China produces important parts including outer body and flight control surfaces as well as cabin equipment. According to a report in 2018, US suppliers accounted for about 50% of C-919 components, while Chinese suppliers accounted for about 15%. French, German and British suppliers accounted for about 20%. And other places around the world accounted for remaining 15%. Many people may think, oh, so it's all imported from abroad, so when will China be able to produce it themselves? Surely producing an airplane is never easy and certainly no country produces all components themselves. However, Western analysts predict that this Chinese man will soon master his own technology thanks to espionage activities. Specifically, COMAC, which produces C919, is said to be researching production of its own engines. The problem lies in that, according to many experts, Chinese people have stolen designs of many other important components from Western companies. For example, in November 2022, a U.S. court sentenced a Chinese citizen to 20 years in prison for stealing the fan blade design of U.S. engine manufacturer General Electric. Fan blades are one of the most important parts of a jet engine, but these fan blades are designed to withstand extremely harsh temperatures and pressures. Only four countries in the world, USA, UK, France and Russia, master this technology. Chinese hackers are also said to have continuously attacked Western technology companies. For example, in 2016, Chinese hackers were accused of stealing the F-135 engine design from Pratt & Whitney. So it is clear that Chinese people know what they need to do to soon produce airplanes and compete with the West. They announced that their newly launched C919 has up to 1,200 orders. If this is true, it seems that both Boeing and Airbus have lost a huge number of customers. This also seems feasible when the price of C919 is only $99 million, while similar models from Boeing cost $121 million and Airbus costs $111 million, both much higher than C919. However, the problem is that China is very dependent on the West, so the airplane war will happen again, especially with the US. Some subsidiaries of COMAC have been labeled as related to the Chinese military, so these companies have been sanctioned by the US, and thus in the future COMAC may face difficulties importing components from the US to produce airplanes. So it seems that the day when Chinese airplanes dominate the sky is still very far away unless China tries to copy production technology that US and its allies exclusively own. Thank you for watching this video. Goodbye and see you again.